Welcome to Ireland, Paulsboro. This is the show we enjoy a great deal doing. This is our Christmas, New Year's, Hanukkah, Kwanzaa show, everything rolled into one. Coming this year again from the home of Gary and Raylan Stevenson. Of course, Gary's the mayor of Paulsboro. We've been here for a number of years in a row because it just lends itself to shooting. Plus, it's beautiful, Irma.
John, it's on the Mantra Creek. And where else would we want to be in Paulsboro, but on the Mantra Creek?
No, it's perfect. I saw Raylan somewhere with a coffee cup. Raylan, please come in. We want you to say hello to Raylan, who's our host. Thank you, Raylan. Thank you.
You're very welcome.
The house is beautiful. How many trees?
Six.
Was that enough?
Well, yeah. I think we could do a little bit more, but we let it go at six.
Well, it's absolutely beautiful, and thank you for having us, because we completely disrupted places to come. We've got a nice audience around it, so hear some applause from time to time. We're going to come right back. We're not sure who's on the show. I haven't had coffee yet, and I can't speak. We do know we have a cooking segment. Dr. Quint's going to join us. Coach Glenn Howard's going to join us at a wonderful football season, and a couple surprises along the way with some Christmas greetings. And also, Mike Smith is with us on his guitar with his magic music, and who knows, maybe even the pastor will sing again as well. So as we go back and forth, there'll be music dropped in, odds and ends, whatever Amy and Fred can put together. So stay with us. Irma, Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas, Happy New Year, Happy Hanukkah and Kwanzaa, and everything else that may 2017 be the best ever.
Well, they're nice sentiments. We'll be right back. On we go.
About a new appliance or an LCD TV? Don't think twice, think Weiss. Weiss True Value has a full line of LCD TVs plus a great variety of appliances. And of course, hardware items like TrueTest paints, Master Mechanic tools, electrical supplies, key duplicating, and Rug Doctor rentals. And for repairs on screens and windows, look no further. Weiss True Value, from making keys to selling appliances and LCD TVs. Don't think twice, think Weiss. 39 West Broad Street, Paulsboro.
For everything, there's a season, and a time for everything under heaven. A time for sharing, a time for caring, a time for remembering, and a time for parting. When that time arrives, let Beth McBride Foley and Thomas D. Foley at the McBride Foley Funeral Home help you in your time of need. Offering a wide variety of funeral services from cremation to traditional, McBride Foley Funeral Home has been helping families with the loss of a loved one with over 50 years of combined service. McBride Foley Funeral Home, 228 West Broad Street, Paulsboro.
With me now is Judy McKenzie. She is the president of the Greater Paulsboro Chamber of Commerce, and of course, Mark Camp, who has just been a stalwart of Paulsboro issues and Paulsboro programs for all these years. But before we get into talking about the Chamber of Commerce and the tree lighting and the procession, we had a wonderful treat here as the Paulsboro Volunteer Fire Company was making their way around town with a special guest of Santa Claus. They stopped by the mayor's house along with Santa Claus and made their way in and brought candy canes. Of course, we all look forward to those. And I actually would prefer a second cup of coffee, but we all got got a candy cane anyway. But for those who enjoyed watching Santa Claus go by, these are all volunteer folks, so we really appreciate them. And Judy, we'll turn very quickly on that, because tree lighting this year had a special highlight, as it has occasionally over the years, because as the Paulsboro High School football team, Glenn's team, had won in Glassboro, it was coordinated by Councilman John Giovanetti and Fire Chief and Councilman Alphonse Jampol and the mayor to coordinate having the kids come back in town with the football team, the band, and the cheerleaders and the coaches to bring those buses right to the municipal building. And so the tree lighting turned into something even bigger.
Oh, it was really such a special night, John, to, you know, we were lucky. The chamber, as you well recall, way back in 1989 when you were president of the chamber, that's when we had our very first tree lighting. Over the years, it bounced around with who hosted, but the chamber, we were very excited to host it again this year. We arranged for the Ed Cole's band to come out and play some music. Wawa came out, gave out lots of hot chocolate, coffee, soft pretzels and hot dogs, and they had a little wheel that you could spin and win some free things. So that was, we were very glad to have all that. When we got word that the team won the championship, of course we were more than happy to kind of stall for about 15 minutes because we had all that entertainment. And only in Paulsboro can you tell a band from National Park play the Paulsboro fight song, and they do.
Of course they do, because everybody knows it. Mark, another big year. Judy mentioned 1989 starting it. That was Tom Lale who donated the first tree. That tree lasted a few years and didn't quite take, and then it was Ida Walker coordinating with then Dale Choate at Mobile Refinery, who purchased the second tree, came from Exley's Nursery. It's a living tree. Mark, it was a good year.
Yes, it was. And in commemoration of Paulsboro High School Centennial, the Paulsboro High School Centennial Committee donated the red and white lights for the tree to be appropriate for the town for this year.
It really looks beautiful, by the way. Just a nice job all the way around. We're going to leave this segment. It's a little bit quick on the interview side. Fred's got footage that Judy shot, because Fred and Amy were both working the football game and couldn't be there for what would be the normal pictures. But Judy, of course, is a video professional. So we expect the pictures are very good. So let's go to the Paulsboro High School football team coming back into town and the tree lighting service at the municipal building.
Hey! Life is a journey that we travel with a lot of uncertainty. When your family is faced with change and you're in need of understanding, direction, honesty, and professionalism, we at the Landolfi Funeral Home have a tradition of assisting you with all of your needs in any way that we can. We offer many affordable funeral services. Please feel free to call us with any questions you may have or visit us at www.landolfifuneralhome.com.
Rizzo Family Chiropractic Center in Gibbstown offers pain relief with a difference. Using specific chiropractic adjustments, Rizzo Family Chiropractic will get to the root of your problem quickly. Bring your headaches, neck, back, joint, or limb pain to Dr. Karen Rizzo. If you have recurring pain, chiropractic can help. Rizzo Family Chiropractic can relieve many sources of pain without extended treatment and ongoing therapy. Give your family the gift of caring professional pain relief with a difference. Rizzo Family Chiropractic.
Come on down Route 55 to the Millville Airport. Visit Smith & Jackson Military Antiques and Firearms, a gun shop with a woman's touch. Buying, selling, and trading firearms and military items, especially seeking World War II, German, Japanese, and American items. Buying single items or entire collections. That's Smith & Jackson Military Antiques and Firearms at the Millville Airport, 21 Peterson Street, next to the Glasstown Brewing Company.
Welcome back once again. I'm happy to pass the microphone to the mayor of the borough of Paulsboro, Gary Stevenson. He and his wife are also our hosts here. I'd like to invite Gary to simply bring us a Christmas greeting as Paulsboro closes out 2016. Gary, I'm just going to pass the mic.
Well, thank you there, Assemblyman. From all of us, all of the government officials, the workers, the professionals, all of us at Borough Hall, we want to wish all of our residents a very Merry Christmas, Happy Hanukkah, Kwanzaa, whatever that holiday you wish to observe. As well as a happy new year and a prosperous new year. Paulsboro's moving forward. We have the port coming online. We have our plaza coming online. We're working on Route 295 development. Our water tower's being fixed. Our streets are being fixed. So Paulsboro's moving in the right direction. We're going to keep moving forward. We're going to think outside the box. We're going to streamline some things, and we're going to expand some departments. It's all to make Paulsboro a better place to live. And once again, my motto is moving Paulsboro forward. So once again, to all of you, a very Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
Strike the harp and join the chorus. La 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 la. Follow me in merry measure. La 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 la. While I tell of Yuletide treasure. La 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 la. Fast away the old year passes. La 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 la. Hail the new ye lads and lasses. La 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 la. Sing we joyous all together, la 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 la. Heedless of the wind and weather, la 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 la.
Dashing through the snow, in a one-horse open sleigh, through the fields we go, laughing all the way. Bells on bobtail shall ring, making spirits bright. What fun it is to ride and sing a sleigh song tonight.
Oh, jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh.
Day or two ago, I'd take a ride, and soon Miss Penny Bright was seated by my side.
filled his mind. He got into a trance and fell completely out of sight.
Oh, jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh.
Friends, good evening. I am Reverend Kevin Davis, a pastor of St. Paul's United Methodist Church here in Paulsboro, and I come to you tonight with a Christmas wish. My wish for all of us, you're going to hear from representatives of the business community, from them to the religious community, and everybody in between. My Christmas wish for all of us is that we will continue in this spirit of unity that we started with the area churches, finally coming together and committing to work together to, as our mayor says all the time, move Paulsboro forward, to go in a positive direction, faith-based and ready to move, ready to work together in that spirit of unity. So my wish and my prayer for all of us is that spirit of unity will continue throughout and long beyond this holiday season. And with that, on behalf of the churches that have come together to work together for this borough and our family at St. Paul's United Methodist Church, I wish you a blessed, happy Hanukkah, a very Merry Christmas, and a beautiful Kwanzaa. Amen.
Multi-policy discount. Paperless discount.
Paid in full discount.
Homeowners discount.
Safe driver discount.
Chipmunk family reunion. Someone stole the nuts. Squirrel jail.
Justice. Countless discounts. Now that's progressive. Call or click today.
Thinking about a new appliance or an LCD TV? Don't think twice. Think Weiss. Weiss True Value has a full line of LCD TVs plus a great variety of appliances. And of course, hardware items like TrueTest paints, Master Mechanic tools, electrical supplies, key duplicating, and Rug Doctor rentals. And for repairs on screens and windows, look no further. Weiss True Value, from making keys to selling appliances and LCD TVs. Don't think twice. Think Weiss. 39 West Broad Street, Paulsboro.
For everything, there's a season, and a time for everything under heaven. A time for sharing, a time for caring, a time for remembering, and a time for parting. When that time arrives, let Beth McBride Foley and Thomas D. Foley at the McBride Foley Funeral Home help you in your time of need. Offering a wide variety of funeral services from cremation to traditional, McBride Foley Funeral Home has been helping families with the loss of a loved one with over 50 years of combined service. McBride Foley Funeral Home, 228 West Broad Street, Paulsboro.
Well, our program has moved to the kitchen, and many people know that a kitchen in a household is where family gathers and sort of special things happen. With us now is Joe Giovanetti, Giovanetti Catering, caterer to the stars. And by the way, that's no exaggeration. We don't say that because he's standing here. Joe does a lot of work with some significant, prominent people in the show business world, not necessarily Hill Studio, but his reputation has grown so wide. So, Joe, it wouldn't be a Christmas program if you weren't with us. We really appreciate that you can
I'm
make
really
your schedule clear.
I'm really happy to be here. I don't know how many years this is now.
We don't talk about 31. That. But Glenn Howard has coached the football team for 30 years, which is stunning to me. I couldn't believe it. What are you going to do for us
today,
Joe?
Today we're going to make nothing healthy.
Good.
Irma.
Yeah, thank God.
We're going to make, no, this is all good food, though. We're going to have potato gnocchi.
Wonderful.
With a couple different sauces. I'm going to do chicken marsala, which, it's a nice holiday dish. And a nice spinach salad with walnuts, candied walnuts, and strawberries, and green apple, in a honey mustard sauce.
Joe, I think dressing. We should get started. Marsala, because that's Mark Kent. Where's Mark at? Mark, that's Mark's favorite dish, veal marsala. Yes.
Well, this is chicken marsala, but there's the same flavors.
Well, we're a low-budget show. We couldn't afford veal.
I don't know. Some people have an issue with the veal, you know. But, okay, so what I'd start with for the gnocchis is Idaho baking potatoes. You want a nice dry potato. Less moisture after the cooking and easier to mix with the flour. It works better than, say, a red skin or whatever. So a russet Idaho potato. These are baked to 210 degrees, nice and soft. And I already riced some, and this is a little handy gadget to have. You don't want to mash potatoes when you're making a gnocchi. You want, because it gets too dense and too gluteny, and
I'm glad you pointed it out, because I would probably try to mash it.
But it makes them kind of heavy, you know. But if you use this ricer, this little handy kitchen style ricer, you just put the potato in here. It's got these little holes in here, and you just press down like this, and you get a nice, light, airy. They call it a ricer because it kind of looks a little like rice when it comes out. I imagine that's why they call it.
In the old days, Italians would use whatever potato was available.
You could use leftover mashed potatoes.
Whatever they could find.
So I took the liberty of doing a few ahead of time.
I'm glad you did, because the segment's not that long.
I know, right. So you get it all off of there. And like, this is 3 pounds of these potatoes cooked in. You know, it'll feed everybody here, probably feed 15 people.
Because we're having a few other things. Interesting that, you know, gnocchis, like polenta, was really peasant food.
It is, definitely.
And now it's become fashionable.
I think so, yeah. Mm-hmm, you're right. It's a lot of work. So what I have is the riced potatoes. I'm going to just put a little bit of salt in there. Wow.
Whoa.
Sounds like the Nutcracker or something. Okay, so we got that little bit of salt in there. And then you're going to put... we're going to start with, well, we have 3 pounds of potatoes. We're going to try like 2 cups of flour to start.
And that's a formal measuring cup of cup there?
Yes. I got it right off of our counter.
Yeah. Yes. Perfect. Perfect.
So we're going to take the clean hands and just start to mix it up.
No gloves?
Nah. I mean, clean hands are okay. As long as they're clean. So we're going to, this flour is going to start to absorb the moisture from the potatoes. These are pretty dry potatoes. So that's half the battle. You can use an egg in here if you like.
I don't know how I feel about an egg.
Some people use eggs in there.
Yeah. It just seems like an extra step.
Well, it kind of holds things together. Like you make pasta and flour, you know, the egg noodles.
I usually open up the plastic container from the freezer.
right. Okay, so what we're at a point now where it's starting to stick together and become like a dough ball. And then I'm going to take this and turn it onto Ray Lynn's countertop. Beautiful, nice surface to work on here.
And that's right after the cat walked on it.
Oh, did he?
Yeah. So. Okay.
Was he up here?
Only repeatedly.
No.
It'll taste better.
It will. Okay. So this, you can see, is coming together real nice.
It's beautiful, Joe.
And the less flour you use with these potato gnocchis, the lighter the end result will be, which is nice. You don't want to, if you put too much flour in there, you know, you could just do that with water and flour, and you'd just have, like, remember we used to make glue out of that as a kid, you know, water and flour.
It's a favorite dish of mine. It's a simple food. It's a favorite dish along mm-hmm. with like a breaded chicken cutlet,
right?
With a lot of red gravy.
Yeah. Well, I'm going to make it with two different. You can use. I have some just traditional, you know, Sunday type gravy. You know,
tomato sauce
gravy, and then I've got another little. I got some things here we can try, like a cream sauce on it too.
Joe, do you need help with that? I think is Coach Howard still here? We may need a little bit of muscle, you know, on the kneading.
Yeah. Don't tell Coach Howard I'm gassing over here.
That's why I asked you, because I could sense that.
I haven't been running my sprints.
So you have run your sprint. Yeah, it's been a long time for that.
You might need him.
Okay, so this is actually... yeah, I got it. I just got that. He might need me, yeah, right? Okay. This is looking pretty good.
Yeah, it's come along nicely. Mm-hmm. Come along nicely.
Okay, so then what we're going to do... is throw a little flour on here on this table, on this countertop. This is actually just perfect.
Well, Joe, of course it's perfect because you're doing it.
Okay. That's about how you want it. It's not really sticking to my hands. It's staying in a ball. Looks great. So we'll just throw a little flour down here. And then we're going to just take a chunk of this. Now you can do this way in advance. You can freeze these pretty nice. Take a little piece of this. We're going to roll it out.
So Joe, as much as it is a simple food,
It's a workout.
I was going to say, it takes a little bit of effort. I mean, but you're doing with potatoes and flour, so the expense of this dish is manageable. I mean,
oh, expenses?
No, that's what I mean. I mean,
you can feed a family. Inexpensive dish you can make, you know, and have a lot of bang for your buck with this. You know what I mean?
It's $18
at
Nino's.
Usually,
and it's delicious. With a lot of things, $18 at Nino's.
You know, the inexpensive things they usually take a little bit more work. You know what I mean?
Well, they do. I mean, that's my comment. I mean, if you're willing to put the effort in,
the
ingredient side is good.
Okay, so what I would do is I would continue to do, we'll just show you a little bit, right? Then we can make the rest later, because I think these people want to eat this, right?
Yeah.
Well, we prefer you cook it first.
Well, I'm not going to sit here and do all of them.
No, because we don't.
Then with the next step I would do is I get kind of an assembly line doing this when I'm doing it for a large party. You know, we'll have a lot of potatoes in a big bowl.
You make them homemade?
Yeah.
On your menu? So if this gnocchi's from Giovanetti Catering,
they're homemade. Yeah.
Okay.
So then what I do is I just cut them like this little, you can make them as big or as small as you want. My mom makes them bigger. My mom makes them smaller. Well, call your mom. You know what I mean? Yeah. What do you want from me? But I always say, well, they're better than mine. I never tell anybody that their mother's is not as good as, you know, what I'm saying is their mom's always right.
Joe, I think you're going to be fine. You're still going to be in the will. You're going to be okay.
Then you take a little fork like this. You know, what happens is you could cook these just like this, but they're not going to be very good at holding the sauce. So you want to put a little dent in them like this.
My grandmother rolled them with her thumb.
You know what?
Yeah, you can do that too. That's what she did.
It puts a little dent in them, but you could use a fork. You can roll them like this, get a little dent in them. And my mom was telling me that when they do it, they bam, 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 they get them going like that. You know, I don't really use this. I use do you ever see those little things you cut dough with and they got the little squiggly cutters on them? I'll run it down the whole thing like this, which I didn't bring with me, but I'll take that thing and I'll just roll it down here and it puts like a wiggle all the way around and I just cut them. It's a lot. For me, it works, you know?
All right, so from here, they go into the water.
From here, they're going to go into the boiling water.
Okay.
Okay, so we'll hold off on that.
That's correct.
We'll do a little bit more of that later.
What do you want to do on this segment?
Now we're going to make the sauce for this. We're going to heat up this oil here. I'll turn this.
Joe, there. Is it sauce or gravy?
This is more of a sauce.
Because there's no meat?
I don't know. How's that for an answer? Gravy. Gravy is something that you're going to be cooking all day long.
That's
and it's usually associated with meat.
Jerry Blabbin said the difference between gravy and sauce is gravy has meat and sauce has no meat.
Oh, well, Jerry Blabbin.
That's Jerry Blabbin.
He's not. The Geeter. All right, so we're going to make, you can do these gnocchis with a nice red sauce. They're going to go great on that, you know. But we're going to do another sauce so you can have it two ways, and it's going to have like pancetta and Italian deli meats and a cream sauce. And what I have here is we've got some supersod, black pepper supersod.
This is
capicole. There's a little pepperoni in here. So I chopped that up, and we're going to crisp it up in this oil over here.
And by the way, this is everything the American Heart Association talks about as far as dining goes.
And you're going to, this is a great thing to do with like leftover pepperoni, or if you have some leftover lunch meat, ham, anything you could do.
Joe, whoever has it leftover? Pepperoni?
You know, I do. Or buy it just for that. We're going to let this get a little brown and crispy, almost like bacon, without burning it. Yeah, it's coming along there.
That's beautiful, Jeff. Beautiful.
It smells nice too, doesn't it?
It really does.
Can you guys smell that?
Yeah.
Sorry, Mark. Ah, there you go. Now I'm going to put a little bit of butter in there with this. Just a little bit of butter in there. And then I am going to add I have some onion, some celery, and some carrot. And that's going to cook down real nice.
Okay. And colorful, too.
Beautiful, nice and
Joe.
Colorful.
Yeah,
it'll look nice against the backdrop of the gnocchis. Okay. I'm going to put a little parsley in there. And just let this cook. And at the end, we're going to add the cream. And that's going to go over top of our gnocchi after this cooks down.
So, Joe, let me sort this out. So you've got processed lunch meats, heavy cream, and butter.
Right.
Okay.
Right.
Okay. Okay.
The cream's going to go in a little bit.
So I guess anyone watching should not plan too far into 2017.
No.
Okay. Okay. We're going to come right.
Okay. Go ahead.
Can we do a break?
Yep.
Can we do a break? We got to do a break because otherwise Amy's going to roll around the floor like Bill Crane did.
All right. All right.
We'd almost like to wait and see that, but we don't have time to do that. We're going to come right back. Joe's going to continue with this dish and on to a second dish. We'll be right back from Ray Lynn's Kitchen.
Welcome to Skin Friends, a comfort store offering natural and organic products. We are your home for aromatherapy, boasting a huge collection of essential oils, burning oils, body and massage oils, hand-dipped incense, and exotic liqueurs. Looking for body butters? Come see our handsome butter bar, stocked with mango, aloe vera, and shea butters. Skin Friends features black seed oil and moringa products. We carry natural topical pain-relieving ointments and over 40 types of natural soaps. Tucked away in the Gibbstown Shopping Plaza off Exit 17 on 295 in New Jersey, Skin Friends has hand-picked products you can count on.
Life is a journey that we travel with a lot of uncertainty. When your family is faced with change and you're in need of understanding, direction, honesty, and professionalism, we at the Landolfi Funeral Home have a tradition of assisting you with all of your needs in any way that we can. We offer many affordable funeral services. Please feel free to call us with any questions you may have or visit us at www.landolfifuneralhome.com.
Rizzo Family Chiropractic Center in Gibbstown offers pain relief with a difference. Using specific chiropractic adjustments, Rizzo Family Chiropractic will get to the root of your problem quickly. Bring your headaches, neck, back, joint, or limb pain to Dr. Karen Rizzo. If you have recurring pain, chiropractic can help. Rizzo Family Chiropractic can relieve many sources of pain without extended treatment and ongoing therapy. Give your family the gift of caring professional pain relief with a difference. Rizzo Family Chiropractic.
Come on down Route 55 to the Millville Airport. Visit Smith & Jackson Military Antiques and Firearms, a gun shop with a woman's touch. Buying, selling, and trading firearms and military items, especially seeking World War II, German, Japanese, and American items. Buying single items or entire collections. That's Smith & Jackson Military Antiques and Firearms at the Millville Airport, 21 Peterson Street, next to the Glasstown Brewing Company.
And welcome back. With a little bit of TV magic, Joe's going to take us right to sort of the finish because, unfortunately, time just keeps ticking along. So, Joe, where are we at?
Okay, well, what we did was we dropped the gnocchis into the boiling water, salted boiling water. When they rise to the top, wait about one more minute and they're done.
Yeah, they're fast too, aren't they, Joe?
I use a strainer to take them out. You don't want to pour them into a sink full of with a colander in there. That kind of beats them up and can beat them up. So you want to take them out with what I call a tennis racket. Anyway, it's just a handheld strainer.
Yep, perfect.
And, you know, poured the sauce on top. That's it's got the Italian deli, sauteed deli meats with tomato and, a little parsley.
It looks beautiful.
Shallots. So now we're going to make a spinach salad, which this has been a big, big hit lately. I'm not one for sweet salads, but this is great. What I have here is just, fresh spinach on a nice tray. I like to lay this out on a tray. And then I make a nice dressing that I'll make real quick. Let me get to the dressing because that's the only thing that's going to be.
Because you've already made the spinach.
I've already made the spinach, right.
Yeah.
What you're going to do, you're going to take about equal parts of red wine vinegar. Not red wine. This is apple cider vinegar. So we're going to use about, a cup.
Joe, that's magic stuff, isn't it? Apple cider vinegar.
If you taste it, it kind of tastes like an apple.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, and what goes in here is about equal parts honey. We got honey here. And I mix this stuff before I put the oil in, I'll put these in. Because it's easier to mix this into vinegar than oil. So what I have in here is just, a little bit of apple cider vinegar, Dijon mustard, and honey. And we're going to whip that up.
That looks good. That looks good.
Okay. So we got that. And then I put a little salt and pepper in it, right? And then I add the oil to it. Here's my oil right here. And you'd like to whisk this while you're pouring the oil in it. Mixes a little bit easier.
So is that an olive oil or just an
this
oil?
Is just, no, I don't use olive oil on this. I use just like a vegetable oil because it has less of a heavy flavor than olive oil would. You want to have the sweetness. You could use olive oil, but I don't know. I like it just with a bland oil to carry it through. So there's your dressing. You can make it a little, I think it needs to be a little bit thicker. I'll add a little bit of honey to that. But then what I do is I top it off with some fresh, I like to use red onion because they're colorful and they're mild.
Oh, they're wonderful.
Then I take these are green Granny Smith apples. We put them on there. And strawberries. So you get the red, the green, Christmassy look. I top that off with blue cheese. This is crumbled blue cheese, right? And then these are nuts, candied walnuts. I make these myself. Nice. You just throw them in a frying pan, pour brown sugar on them, saute them, let them cool. Kind of like you're making peanut brittle. These are homemade. Want to try one?
I usually get them out of a jar.
Right. Well, then, yeah, these are way, way better than an out of a jar, and they're a lot less expensive.
I'm sure of that.
Yeah, yeah. Watch your teeth. They're candy. So, and then I just sprinkle them on top. Then what you do is you take this dressing and you just drizzle it right over the top. And you want to pour this dressing on just before you serve it.
Do the walnuts.
So we're going to be eating soon.
Really, really nice.
Right? That's the spinach salad.
So we're going to have gnocchis and we're going to have spinach salad.
Yep.
I mentioned at the top of this, we'd have two dishes. Because of our time frame, the second dish will appear in the next show.
Happy New Year.
That gives you a reason. That gives you a reason why. Joe, before we leave the segment, first of all, thank you again.
Oh, you're welcome.
A wonderful dish, homemade with a great deal of love. Phone number for people that are interested in having you maybe help them with the affair.
Yeah, 609-876-0612 or friend me on Facebook.
Facebook.
Joe Giovanetti, Facebook. Giovanetti Catering as well.
If you have an occasion where you need a caterer, I tell you, looking straight into the camera, that you can't go wrong if you call Joe Giovanetti, because as Joe would say, any occasion is...
any occasion of pleasure will take good care of you.
And he will take very good care of you.
Mention the Island Paulsboro for a discount,
10%.
10%? Yeah.
10%.
Mention Island Paulsboro.
We will be right back. We can't wait to have this. And you'll, as we close the show out, we'll be sitting at a table enjoying it. Joe, I can't thank you enough. Merry Christmas, Dave.
My pleasure.
Thank you. We'll be right back.
Multi-policy discount. Paperless discount.
Paid in full discount.
Homeowners discount.
Safe driver discount.
Chipmunk family reunion.
Someone stole the nuts.
Squirrel jail.
Justice.
Countless discounts. Now that's progressive. Call or click today.
Thinking about a new appliance or an LCD TV? Don't think twice. Think Weiss. Weiss True Value has a full line of LCD TVs plus a great variety of appliances. And of course, hardware items like TrueTest paints, Master Mechanic tools, electrical supplies, key duplicating, and Rug Doctor rentals. And for repairs on screens and windows, look no further. Weiss True Value, from making keys to selling appliances and LCD TVs. Don't think twice. Think Weiss. 39 West Broad Street, Paulsboro.
For everything, there's a season, and a time for everything under heaven. A time for sharing, a time for caring, a time for remembering, and a time for parting. When that time arrives, let Beth McBride Foley and Thomas D. Foley at the McBride Foley Funeral Home help you in your time of need. Offering a wide variety of funeral services from cremation to traditional, McBride Foley Funeral Home has been helping families with the loss of a loved one with over 50 years of combined service. McBride Foley Funeral Home, 228 West Broad Street, Paulsboro.
Welcome back once again. This year is a very special year. Of course, we head into Christmas, which is a dedicated calendar, December 25th. But also, many of our friends, all of our friends who happen to be of Jewish faith, are celebrating Hanukkah, which unusually comes at the same time. Mark, you've got the candle lit. What makes it such a special year this year? Of course, Hanukkah is always special for the Jewish faith, but why so special this year?
Well, this year is special because the first night of Hanukkah falls on Christmas Eve. And according to statistics, this is only the fourth time it's happened since 1900. 1902, 1940, 1978, and this year. So this may be only the second time in my lifetime that this will happen.
Wonderful. And of the procedure here, the first candle?
Yes. Each night we start with a candle, one each night throughout the 8 days of Hanukkah, we add another candle. So since this should be airing Christmas Eve, this will be the first night.
That, from your lips to God's ears, Christmas Eve. That's if they can get it edited. But why don't you pick it up from there? I'll hold the mic for you.
Okay. As we light the candles, we have blessings to say. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam, Asher Kitchanu B'Mitzvasav V'Tzivanu L'Hadlik Ner Shel Hanukkah. Blessed are you, Lord our God, King of the universe, who sanctified us with his commandments and has commanded us to kindle the lights of Hanukkah. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam, Shal Sonisim Lavoseinu B'Yomim Ha'ayim Bazman Hazeh. Blessed are you, Lord our God, King of the universe, who wrought miracles for our fathers in days of old at this season. And the third blessing is only said on the first night. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam, Shehechiyanu V'Kiyemanu V'Higiyanu L'Zman Hazeh. Blessed are you, Lord our God, King of the universe, who has kept us alive and has preserved us and enabled us to reach this season.
Very nice. And the first candle gets lit. We'll be right back. Happy Hanukkah.
Here we come, a wassailing among the leaves so green. Here we come, a wandering so fair to be seen. Love and joy come to you, and to you your wassail too. And God bless you and send you a happy new year. And God send you a happy new year. We are not daily beggars that beg from door to door, but we are neighbors' children whom you have seen before. Love and joy come to you, and to you your wassail too, and God bless you and send you a happy new year, and God send you a happy new year.
Life is a journey that we travel with a lot of uncertainty. When your family is faced with change and you're in need of understanding, direction, honesty, and professionalism, we at the Landolfi Funeral Home have a tradition of assisting you with all of your needs in any way that we can. We offer many affordable funeral services. Please feel free to call us with any questions you may have or visit us at www.landolfifuneralhome.com.
Rizzo Family Chiropractic Center in Gibbstown offers pain relief with a difference. Using specific chiropractic adjustments, Rizzo Family Chiropractic will get to the root of your problem quickly. Bring your headaches, neck, back, joint, or limb pain to Dr. Karen Rizzo. If you have recurring pain, chiropractic can help. Rizzo Family Chiropractic can relieve many sources of pain without extended treatment and ongoing therapy. Give your family the gift of caring professional pain relief with a difference. Rizzo Family Chiropractic.
Come on down Route 55 to the Millville Airport. Visit Smith & Jackson Military Antiques and Firearms, a gun shop with a woman's touch. Buying, selling, and trading firearms and military items, especially seeking World War II, German, Japanese, and American items. Buying single items or entire collections. That's Smith & Jackson Military Antiques and Firearms at the Millville Airport, 21 Peterson Street, next to the Glasstown Brewing Company.
And welcome back. We hope you're enjoying the segues in and out of these segments, because I'm not really sure what you're saying, because we're going to piece the whole thing together. That's the magic of editing with both Fred and Amy. But with me now is Coach Glenn Howard, the Paulsboro High School football team. All of you know him. Many of you are old enough to remember him playing, both through the midget ranks and through his high school career. Went on to play at the University of Minnesota. Went on to play professionally at the United States. It was USFL, correct?
Yeah, Glenn,
USFL. A star. I saw many of those games as well. He comes off a year of winning the Group 1 championship, a magnificent year, and the schedule permitted him to come by and say hello, because people like to catch up with the coach. We don't cover sports during the year on a weekly basis because of our taping schedule. It would not be fresh, but we can always do these catch-up things. So first of all, Glenn, welcome, and thanks for coming over on a Sunday. And congratulations. You've had some big years. This seemed to be a pretty special year in the fact of the kids, as you worked with them, seemed to grow as the year went on. I thought you had a great coaching year.
Yeah, the kids did a great job responding to
the assistant coaches and what we tried to establish with them. We lost our first game to Woodbury, and we made a lot of mistakes. Woodbury played real well, and they deserved to win. But we looked at the film and said there's a lot of things we can do to get better. And we concentrated and focused each week on little things to try to get the kids to improve. And they really bought into it. And week by week, they improved and got better. And then we just hit a stride where we were playing pretty good football and got hot and, you know, had a great season.
I thought it seemed to come together. Glassboro seemed to be a bigger team. And you guys hung in there and pulled that game together. And you mentioned hitting stride. It seemed to really come together in the Haddonfield game.
Yeah, we hadn't beaten Haddonfield for 3 years, and that was a key game for us. Kids played really well offensively and defensively, and we made some big plays when we had to. Some kids really stepped their game up, and that was a big win for us. And that propelled us for the second half of the season.
Seemed to bring a lot of confidence. The offense seemed to have gelled, and in a number of cases, you know, you were outsized, but you weren't out-hearted. I mean, I watched those little kids hold on to some of those big players, and they showed no fear.
Yeah, we pride ourselves on Paulsboro pride and getting the kids to play hard every week, and they really exhibited that mindset throughout the season, especially in the championship game against Salem. We were very proud of how hard we played.
I was impressed. I watched you change your offense. Of course, you started with the George DeLeon offense to some extent,
right,
and evolved now to no huddle. I mean, the fact that you can run a high school team in many cases with no huddle and seamlessly, you know, that you're dealing with young kids.
Yeah, we put it in 3 years ago, and we've had a lot of success with it. The kids really enjoy it because it revolves around a lot of hand signals, a lot of names, which they take part in making up, you know, nicknames for certain plays. We ask them and actually go to them and say, what can you guys remember for us to execute this play? So they have a lot of input, and I think that makes it fun for them. But it's been real successful for us.
A couple of points before we get to the Salem game, because and Fred and Amy have footage to drop in, a couple of games that were able to be shown on television. The Pennsville playoff game, that, you know, Pennsville came into town expecting to win. They didn't win.
Yes, we played Pennsville in 2015, last year, at Pennsville. We were up 13-0 at halftime, and they outplayed us in the second half and came back and won that game. They went on to win the Group 1 championship, and we really felt as though that was ours for the taking. We just, you know, didn't play well enough that day to get the job done. So it was really a lot of – probably a little bit of revenge factor this year. It was on our home field. So the kids knew if we won that game, we had to win that game to get to Rowan. So that was a big game for us, and we played really well that day.
And played hard. They had a nice-looking running back, nice-looking football team. That was a physical football game. And then you move on to there, and then you have West Effort, and you go toe-to-toe. West Effort goes on in an undefeated season to win the Group 2 championship, and you were toe-to-toe just about the whole game.
Yes, the West Effort game, we were just overmatched. They had a great football team. They were undefeated this year. Coach Folsom did a fantastic job, and like you said, we were going toe-to-toe for the first half, and then we had some turnovers in the second half, and they stretched the lead, and we just couldn't recover. But thank God the kids came back the next week, put that one behind us. We didn't even watch the film on that. We just started preparing for Salem on that Monday after the West Effort game, and had a great week of practice, and got a chance to win the Group 1 championship.
And that's the second time you've seen Salem in the Group 1 championship at Rowan. Almost 5,000 people there. Last time you saw them there, it was in the driving rain, if I remember. I got to be at that one. Had a large crowd, and they had two big-time running backs, and I thought a really nice-size offensive line. That's where I make the mention. I mean, young Holloway's got to weigh 140 pounds. I mean, if it's 160, it's generous. I watched him tackle that big running back in open field. He just latched on to him.
Yes. Kids played really hard, as I said before. Very proud of their effort. We knew Salem had a really big offensive line, really big running back in Taylor, and the other kid, I think his name is Jones, 25. He was a really good running back with a lot of speed. So we had our work cut out for us. But like I said, the kids prepared well. We thought we went in with a pretty good game plan. We knew we probably couldn't stop Taylor. But if we would limit him, limit his big runs, and just contain him, That was our goal, and that's what we did. I mean, he still had 185 yards, 37 carries, and two touchdowns, which is a great day for a back. But we did enough where we contained him enough where we could have a chance to win the game.
Well, he goes on to play at Wisconsin, so he's going to get used to what it's like to wear red and white. So his career is going to continue to grow. I turn television on at 11 o'clock and see SportsCenter, ESPN, and the second highlight of all of America was your kid catching a touchdown in the end zone.
Yeah, we're real proud of Matt. That's just the way he played every game this season, though. He sell out and lay his body on the line every single game in practice. He would dive and make catches. He had a catch very similar to that, I think, in the Haddonfield game where we needed a first down. It was a third down and a third down conversion. And he laid out, went parallel to the ground just like he did in the championship game, made the catch so we could get a first down. But that's just the heart of a champion. That's the way Matt plays football.
Well, because that's the way his coach conducts himself. And I've always said that your success, and I watch Paul and basketball coach as well, Collins, these kids respond to you because they trust you. And with today's kids, that's just a big part of this, I think. It's not like the old days when Ray Zingler would just scream at you, and you would do what you were told to do. You can scream at them. They just won't come back. But these kids that you bring along, it seems they grow, and they conduct themselves well on the field. You as a coach have to be proud.
Yes, we're very proud of them. I just thank God for the opportunity to work with them. And we have a real good staff. I give a lot of credit to my assistant coaches. They do a great job and have a great relationship with the kids. And the kids respond to our coaching. We coach them pretty hard, but they respond to us. And the results are, you know, Group 1 championship.
Glenn, how many years are you coaching now? Because I remember your first year, but I can't remember what year it was.
This is my 30th year.
That can't be possible. First of all, you don't look like you've aged at all. And time stands still. I'm watching on YouTube, Kevin Harvey, quarterback in Temple University against Virginia Tech. Right. I mean, where does the time go? Now he's on the sidelines with you.
Yeah, Kevin's one of our best coaches. He does a great job, and we're very fortunate to have him on the sideline. It was great having him as a player. It's great having him as a coach also.
Glenn, we appreciate you very much. And 30 years well spent because not only is he a successful football coach, but even more so a successful teacher and a successful person. And I mean it sincerely. The score on the field means one thing, but the kids trust him, trust his staff, and they're all better for being in that environment. Goes a long way. Coach, thank you very much. Merry Christmas to you. We'll be right back.
Multi-policy discount. Paperless discount.
Paid in full discount.
Homeowners discount.
Safe driver discount.
Chipmunk family reunion.
Someone stole the nuts.
Squirrel jail.
Justice.
Countless discounts. Now that's progressive. Call or click today.
Thinking about a new appliance or an LCD TV? Don't think twice. Think Weiss. Weiss True Value has a full line of LCD TVs plus a great variety of appliances. And of course, hardware items like TruTest paints, Master Mechanic tools, electrical supplies, key duplicating, and Rug Doctor rentals. And for repairs on screens and windows, look no further. Weiss True Value, from making keys to selling appliances and LCD TVs. Don't think twice. Think Weiss. 39 West Broad Street, Paulsboro.
For everything, there's a season, and a time for everything under heaven. A time for sharing, a time for caring, a time for remembering, and a time for parting. When that time arrives, let Beth McBride Foley and Thomas D. Foley at the McBride Foley Funeral Home help you in your time of need. Offering a wide variety of funeral services from cremation to traditional, McBride Foley Funeral Home has been helping families with the loss of a loved one with over 50 years of combined service. McBride Foley Funeral Home, 228 West Broad Street, Paulsboro.
Welcome to Skin Friends, a comfort store offering natural and organic products. We are your home for aromatherapy, boasting a huge collection of essential oils, burning oils, body and massage oils, hand-dipped incense, and exotic liqueurs. Looking for body butters? Come see our handsome butter bar stocked with mango, aloe vera, and shea butters. Skin Friends features black seed oil and moringa products. We carry natural topical pain-relieving ointments and over 40 types of natural soaps. Tucked away in the Gibbstown Shopping Plaza, off exit 17 on 295 in New Jersey, Skin Friends has hand-picked products you can count on.
And welcome back. The cat just meowed in the back, just as Fred said to go. It's the kind of show it is. We hope you'd enjoyed it. This is always a nice evening, and we're very grateful to both Gary and Ray Lynn for having us into their homes, because there's been a lot of traffic through here. Irma, a couple things. We don't do commuter notes, but Amy and Fred were at the Moose. They had crab cakes. That's developing into a nice event. Amy said she enjoyed it. And she got some pictures of it. So to the Moose, we really appreciate all of you, the men and women of the Moose, and what you do for town. And Irma, this is a night that ties together generations. Gary's father, your husband's train set, runs tonight near Christmas.
Yes, it does. 1941, his dad bought it for him, and we've turned it to Gary since he's our son now. It's his, and he just enjoys it, and we enjoy seeing that it's running, and we're very blessed, John. We're very blessed this year in Paulsboro. Paulsboro is moving forward with our churches. You got to get God in the picture. If you don't have God in the picture, you're not going to go ahead. And I'm very blessed. My mother's still with us on Wood Street, 96 years old, and the mine is fine. And we're blessed. We're very blessed. The people here tonight, they're all friends, family. That's what Paulsboro's about, John. And that's what Paulsboro, we're really moving on. And God's help, we're going to do it.
Oh, we are. And to Mike Smith, we thank him for the music. Raylan, you're off to the side. You've got something very important.
Thanks.
And I want to make sure you're...
Thank you. It's not too hot either. Thank you. It's very good.
Don't worry, folks. It's not steaming.
We appreciate Mike Smith coming over music-wise. Right. And Irma, another wonderful evening to Fred behind the camera, for Amy, for the hard work. This show comes together. There's a lot of pieces to this. To Bill Crane, our producer, who could not be here, but I sort of think he is. Pretty special.
Bill's always with us, John. I always feel that I see him slapping down the board or hollering at us in time, but he's always here with us, John.
He was the best. And Amy just did her invitation, which meant we have to wrap up. So I'm going to wrap up. And to Beth, who's watching, I told you I'd say hello again. Yeah. To everyone, a Merry Christmas. For those celebrating Hanukkah, a Happy Hanukkah. For those who enjoy Kwanzaa, Happy Kwanzaa as well. And this show will roll right into New Year. So may Christmas go for many days. May Hanukkah and Kwanzaa go for many days into the New Year. And may you just have a wonderful new year. And as Joe Giovanetti, caterer to the stars, likes to say, when you have a chance, say something nice about Paulsboro. But most importantly, be kind to someone. Be kind to a stranger. Surprise somebody. You'd be surprised how far a smile goes. Irma's going to do it.
God bless America. God bless Paulsboro. See you on Broad Street, and go be great.
Until next time.
Life is a journey that we travel with a lot of uncertainty. When your family is faced with change and you're in need of understanding, direction, honesty, and professionalism, we at the Landolfi Funeral Home have a tradition of assisting you with all of your needs in any way that we can. We offer many affordable funeral services. Please feel free to call us with any questions you may have or visit us at www.landolfifuneralhome.com.
Rizzo Family Chiropractic Center in Gibbstown offers pain relief with a difference. Using specific chiropractic adjustments, Rizzo Family Chiropractic will get to the root of your problem quickly. Bring your headaches, neck, back, joint, or limb pain to Dr. Karen Rizzo. If you have recurring pain, chiropractic can help. Rizzo Family Chiropractic can relieve many sources of pain without extended treatment and ongoing therapy. Give your family the gift of caring professional pain relief with a difference. Rizzo Family Chiropractic.
Come on down Route 55 to the Millville Airport. Visit Smith & Jackson Military Antiques and Firearms, a gun shop with a woman's touch. Buying, selling, and trading firearms and military items, especially seeking World War II, German, Japanese, and American items. Buying single items or entire collections. That's Smith & Jackson Military Antiques and Firearms at the Millville Airport, 21 Peterson Street, next to the Glasstown Brewing Company.
Why would I have a view?